We are going to discuss problem solving using algorithms and flowcharts. Just like I told you that in computer we have to give instructions to computers so as to be able to solve our problems. But before you give the instruction, you must put the whatever things you want together in a specific way so that you'll be able to solve the problem. So the two basic tools that we can use in problem solving are what? Our algorithms and what? Flowcharts. Okay? So for us to be able to write our program, we must first of all try as much as try to put the instructions together. But we must follow some set of steps. And the first on the list of the steps is to try as much as possible to develop an algorithm for the instruction. This algorithm will be represented in the tutorial form that refers to as flowcharts. By that we put it together, we can try as much as possible to now write the program in a specific computer language. So we have a number of programming languages that we can make it work. By the time we write the program, we try to enter the program into the computer so that the computer will now work on the instruction so as to give the result to our problem and tell us that we have been able to solve our problem. By the time we now enter the program, the best thing for us to try as much as possible to test the program we have written. Okay? Yes. Where there are errors, we try to correct the errors. And the process of correcting the errors is nothing but what? Debugging. We must test and debug the program. Exactly. Yes. So by the time we are done with that, now we now try to run the program. So when the program runs successfully, we now supply the data that we need. We input the data, okay, into the system. And the system will make use of this data, following the instruction that we are giving as programs. And we have our results from the computer via our input, I mean our output units, just like I told you in our previous class. Okay? That the unit where you have your result is nothing but where? The output unit. So by the time you have all of this, then you can try to solve whatever problem you want to solve. So having said this, we now go to what an algorithm is. What is an algorithm? A number of definitions exist for what algorithm is. But whatever way or whichever way you define your algorithm, they all point to the same thing. And for the benefit of this class, I've been able to define algorithm in four different ways, which I will explicitly explain to you that they all point to the same thing, that is providing solution to our problem. And the first definition is telling us that an algorithm is nothing but a detailed sequence of simple steps that we need to solve the problem. Take note, detailed sequence of simple steps. That means we have this step to solve our problem, but we must follow the steps in a sequential order so as to be able to get our result. For example, if we want to compute the addition of three numbers, in the course of that, you must be able to specify the numbers, the first number, the second number, the third number as inputs. And you try to tell the system that by the time you take the first number, the next thing is to put an operator. The operator now will be either addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division on the second number. And after the second number, you bring in another operator, which may either be addition or subtraction, or what? Multiplication as well as what? Division. To know the specific operator I want to do on the third value. So for example, if you want to add three numbers, for example, 5, 9, and 11. It means we have to take the three numbers, 5, 9, 11, as our input, as our data. And we have to follow the steps one after the other. Now you take number 5, add to number 9. After that, you add the result to number 11, sequentially until you are done. So the second definition says that an algorithm is a set, is a process or set of rules to be followed. Okay? To be what? Followed. Look at this one, to be followed, which is nothing but a sequence, detailed sequence. Okay? In problem solving. The other one now says effective method express the final keys of well-defined instructions. The instruction there is nothing but what? Sequence of steps. Okay? You must give me an instruction on how to do the thing. And I have to follow the instruction sequentially. The order in which you are giving what? The instruction. Otherwise, I won't be able to achieve the result. I must follow the sequence. The order in which you are giving what? The instruction. So, the fourth one is now saying that algorithm is a sequence of unambiguous instructions. Look up. You have the other one, final keys of what? Well-defined instructions. This one now is saying that sequence of unambiguous instructions. That is, the instruction must be clear, not having dual or different meanings. It should be well-defined. So, again, you have all of these definitions. They all point to the same thing, following what? The sequence of steps on, I mean, to solve what? Your problem. So, and that is the definition for algorithm. This algorithm I will talk about has a number of properties. Okay? It has a number of properties. The first property is nothing but what? Finiteness. Finiteness in the sense that when you follow the steps, it must get to a point where it will what? Stop. Terminate. Or what? End. Okay? It must follow a sequence of steps to a particular point where it will do what? End. So that is finiteness. So if it does not terminate, it means that it continue with the work till the kingdom come. So if nothing stops it, it will be going down. And at the end of the day, you don't achieve, you won't be able to get your result. Something must put an end to what? The algorithm. And by the time we'll be writing algorithm, you see it now, that we have a statement that terminates what? The algorithm. And that is a property that will pass to us what? Finiteness. The other one is definiteness. Okay? By this we mean that the step that you are following must be precisely defined. Precisely, but must be such that it is an exact way to which you can do a particular operation. Okay? The actions we carry out must be unambiguous. That is not having different meanings. It has to be stated well or clearly stated so that you can have the expected result. The other one is input. Recall the other time I said we want to add three numbers together. Okay? If we have to add three numbers together, we don't have the numbers. We don't know the numbers to sum together, to add together, then we cannot what? Get our results. So input is such that you must be able to have data that you put into the system so as to be able to get your result. So we have these inputs to be such that we have zero input, that is nothing to process, or more than one input, as many as possible, so that you can put all of these things together so as to get our what? Expected results. Okay? Then we have output. Output is such that by the time you have the input in the system, with the various instructions given, you must be able to get your what? Your results. Okay? And this result, we have to come, come out relative to what? The input you have what? Supplied. Okay? And this result will be in line with the instruction that you are giving. For example, you want to sum three numbers together. If we have, just like I said the other time, 5, 9, 10, and 11, and we have supplied these values, 5, 9, 10, and 11, with the operator's addition, at the end of the day, our output will be such that we are going to have what? 25. That is, we add 5 to 9, which is 14, and that 14 out to 11, which will be what? 25. The 25 now is our what? Output. So your result will be 1, your result will be 2, your result will be many. For example, if I want to process the result or I want to compute the results for the 100 students, it means that I'm going to have how many results? 100 results, unlike the summation of three numbers will give you one result. Because the result for this lady is not going to be the same thing as this lady. It will be the same thing, but their programs may not what? Be the same. It means that by the time you are putting in their scores, the courses you are entering as the input will not be the same. Are you there?
Yes.
So for the computation, it's like you are going to have some set of instructions as algorithm that have to be followed on how to get their what? CGPA. We'll go to that one when you get to programming aspects. So the last property there is effectiveness. Effectiveness is such that the set of instructions that you have now will be able to carry out a specific instruction exactly the way it is needed. Okay? And by the time you do that, if you have to go through a specific length of time or period or the kind of operation that you want to do. So, the operation must be performed sufficiently basic that it can be done exactly the way you need it. So these are the five basic properties of
algorithm.